What you are looking at is a highly unusual yet famous monolith in the remote outback of Australia. Known as Uluru or Ayers Rock, this gorgeous geologic oddity stands at 348 meters or 1,142 feet above the surrounding desert. It turns a beautiful red color during sunset, marking it as one of the most well-known geologic features in all of Australia. Taking a closer look at this beautiful formation, we can note how much of its edifice has been heavily tilted to about 85 degrees. This hints at a long-term period of geologic stress and deformation, which led to the formation of both Uluru and the similarly named Kata Tjuta to the west. The event I'm referring to also created a snow-covered mountain range as tall as the modern Himalayas on the western half of the border between South Australia and the Northern Territory. This mountain range has since almost completely eroded away, leaving small foothills in the landscape which are today referred to as the Petermann Range. For context, Uluru is located in the southern portion of Australia's Northern Territory, where it is 340 kilometers southwest of the city of Alice Springs. The story of Uluru began around 550 million years ago when the Australian continent was located north of the planet's equator. At the time, the eastern half of the continent was below sea level, and a single plant had yet to colonize land. As a result, much of the continent had a brown or gray hue due to the complete lack of vegetation. And, to the southwest of the barren landmass, the Indian continent was on a collision course with ancient Australia. Once it collided, it began a massive mountain-building event in central Australia, known as the Petermann Orogeny. Over the next 15 to 20 million years, large swaths of the existing crust were forced upwards by as much as 5,000 meters or 16,400 feet, forming a cluster of tightly packed snow-covered peaks which were rich in granite. Once the orogeny ended, these mountains began rapidly eroding away due to wind and water, where a network of river channels and valleys carried finely grained material downslope. In these river channels, boulders of rock were eroded by the force of the water, forming numerous rounded cobbles of material. These cobbles were continually transported further and further downhill until they ended up in a spread-out area known as an alluvial fan on the northern flank of the massive mountain range. This material would form the beginnings of Kata Tjuta. Further downslope, these cobbles were even further eroded to the point that they became sands and gravels. Over time, these piled up in a series of sand dunes beginning to form what is known as Arco sandstone, that is, a sandstone which is rich in feldspar, typically originating from granite. After the erosion largely ceased until the beginning of the Permian period, sandstones and shales buried the two future monoliths. While this deposition was occurring, a mountain-building event known as the Alice Springs orogeny heavily faulted and folded the existing rocks. The high point of one such fold of the future Uluru was eventually eroded away, creating a near-vertical section of rock. To the west, Kata Tjuta was only slightly tilted. Over the next 285 million years, faulting and folding continued to a lesser extent. Erosion intensified, preferentially cutting away older sedimentary rock, while largely leaving the younger material. Eventually, two hard points of sandstone and conglomerate remained, which we see today as Uluru and Kata Tjuta. These two beautiful monoliths will likely remain in the landscape for at least another 100 million years. However, as seen by the remnants of several recent landslides at Uluru, erosion is still ongoing. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron Grizz Jam for supporting this channel.